Psalm 68, verse 19. Conquest. God would make his enemies, which are the enemies of his people, flee and scatter and step back and move out of the way or be destroyed. Why he, God, at the same time would go before you in his own majestic maneuvers to release strength and success. Come on, and strength and success. Strength and success to all those who love him. Y'all have to pay attention today. I need you to stay with me today. God is dealing with them. And he deals with them about no limits and no lack. No limits and no lack. He deals with them. He commands them, let God arise. Why? Because you're going to have a life of no limits and no lack. Somebody ain't going to get it this morning. I can already tell. No limit and no lack. He tells them in advance, let God arise. Why? Because you're going to deal with folk who are going to try and put you in bondage in your mind. Before they enslave your body, they're going to enslave your mind. In Leviticus 26 verse 8, God promised them, and five of you shall chase 100, and 100 of you shall put 10,000 to flight, and your enemies shall fall before you by the sword. Then in Deuteronomy 32 verse 29 and verse 30, God declares, oh, that they were wise, talking about Israel. Oh, that they would pay attention. Oh, that they would know their power. Oh, that they were wise, that they understood this, that they would consider their latter end. How should one chase 1,000 and two put 10,000 to flight, except their rock had sold them and the Lord had shut them up? You see, God proved to them that he had all power. Power to endow one Israelite with the strategic wisdom and warfare to defeat 1,000 Canaanites. You can utter one prayer and all of your enemies fall. You can utter one prayer. You can make one petition. You can open your mouth and make one prayer. Would never lack the ability to up 20,000 angels. Daily, he dispatches. Daily, God dispatches his chariots. The chariots are descriptive and represent the angels of God. So daily, God releases thousands of 20,000 hosts of angels that fill the earth to minister to his people, to cover our dreams and our visions of victory, to protect our thoughts, our marriages, our children, our seed, even before we get pregnant, our families, and even our finances. God sends angels to make sure we never go back. It was not the Middle East that reduced the oil. It was the angels that guarded over our pocket. It is not a health care bill that's going to take care of us. It is the 20,000 of angels that